Hello, hi, welcome to my channel Avas Computer Learning. My name is Tarika Dedipya. How are you friends? I am doing great. What about you? Write in the comment section. So today's topic is CSS borders, lesson number 7. So CSS borders property. The CSS border property allows you to specify the style, width and color of an element borders. So here we have the borders on all sides. We have bottom border, we have rounded border, and we have colorful colon left border. So we have different types of border right over here. So CSS border style. The border style property specifies what kind of border to display. The following values are allowed: dotted, that defines a dotted border; dashed, that defines the dashed border, that means it will come dash 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 like that; solid, that will define a solid border, it will be in a thick line; double, defines a double border, so it will be in a double line border. Next we have some like grovy, right, and inset, outset, none and hidden. Also we have these many of borders. Also grovy defines that 3D grooved border, and that affects depends on the border color value also. And right defines a 3D right border, that affects the depending on the color border color value. Inset defines a 3D inset border, the effect depending on the color border color value. Outset also same way as a 3D outset border, that affects depends on the border color value only. And none is, it defines no border. We can't, if we won't write any border, that is none. So hidden also, we can hidden our border also, it defines a hidden border. So these are the border styles property can have from 1 to 4 values for the top border and right border, bottom border and the left border. We have these types of border properties. And now this is an example for the demonstration for of the different border styles. So you can try by yourself or else wait for my notepad explanation. Here we have this property specifies what kind of border to display. So you can skip or you can pause and write the elements, and you can try by yourself or else wait for my notepad explanation. But one note, none of the other CSS border properties describes below will have any effect unless the borders dash style property is set. So here we have border dash style dot dot, so it should be set like this, otherwise it will not come the border styling. So we have to, that is important, that border dash style property should be written, we should be set. So none of the other CSS border property describes below will have any effects unless the border dash style property is set. So next we have the CSS border width. The border width property specifies the width of the 4 borders. The width can set as a specific size or by using one of the 3 predefined values like thin, medium or thick. So the border width property can have from 1 to 4 values, like for top border, right border, bottom border and the left border. This example is for the border width. So you can try by yourself or else you can wait for my notepad explanation. So we have more like here we have the border width 5 pixel, border width medium, border width 2 pixel, border width thick, border width 15 pixel, border width thick, border width and every value for which side, for right, bottom and top and left side also. So here in the level 7th one we have the three different size of the width of the border. So now the CSS border color. The CSS border color property is used to set the color of the 4 borders. The color can be set by like name, it specifies a color name like red. So hexa, we have seen already about these colors also. It specifies a hexa like hashtag FF0000. We have seen about this color. RGB. RGB specifies a RGB color like RGB 255, 0, 0. And transparent also like alpha adding a RGBA and HSL game. So we can add the transparent color also. The border color property can have from 1 to 4 values, and for the top border, right border and bottom border and the left border, if the border color is not set, it inherits the color of the element. This is the example for the border colors. You can write, try by yourself, or else wait for my notepad explanation. So we can add any other colors also from the RGB hexa also and HSL also. So we can add any color for the border also. So next we are going to see about the CSS border individual sides. From the example above, you have seen that it is possible to specify a different border for each size. So in this CSS, there are also properties for specifying each of the border, like top, right, bottom and left. I have given you a 2 examples for the border individuality size. This is the one, here is now, it works if the border style property has 4 values. So the border property, if it has a 4 values, it will be work. And this example, the example above, given the same result as this. So we have written the dotted solid also, so that it will be a same result. If the border style dotted solid double, okay, now if the border style property has 4 values, like border style dot dot dotted solid double dash, that means it will be a top border is dotted, like I have shown in the first image. Now top border will be dot 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 and solid means that will be in the thick, that will be in the right side, and double will be in the bottom, and left side will be the dashes. If you want to see about this example, you have to see my notepad explanation. I will be give very clear explain in notepad also, so don't miss my tomorrow's class, or else I'll give in my description also, you can see. And if the border style property has the 3 values, that means border style dot dot dotted solid double, if we write the value like dotted solid double, the top border is dotted, right and left will be solid, and bottom border is the double lined. So if the border style property has 2 values, that means border dash style dotted and solid, the top and bottom, I'm telling again, the top and the bottom border are dotted, right and left will be in the solid value. So if the border style property has only 1 value, the border style is dotted, all 4 borders are dotted. So this is the small tip for you to add a border styles. So the border style property is used in this example above, however it also works with the border width and border color also. So now we are going to see about the CSS border shortened property. As you can see from the example above, there are many properties to consider when dealing with the borders. So to shorten the code, it is also possible to specify all the individual borders property in one property. So the border property is a shortened property for the following individual border properties. So border width, border style. Border style can be, it will be a required one. So border color. And we use regularly width, style and color as usual, as we if it is required, we write the we can write, or else we can write 5 pixel green. So style, border style is very important. If we write 5 pixel and red, it won't work, because if there is no border, it will be a thin line. It will be a border, but it will be thin line. If you want to color it, you can add the style also. If you don't want to color it, if you don't want any thick or dotted or any other design for your border, you can skip that. But width and color will be important, or else you can if you write only border, you can also write the style like normal, none, border dot dot none also you can write. So and here I have given you a 3 examples You can also specify all the individuality borders property for just one slide. You can try by yourself or else wait for my notepad example. This one is a third one, left border. Second one, sorry, this one is a first example. This one is a second example. You can also specify all the individuality border properties for just one side. Okay. Next, this one is the bottom border for the bottom color. Here I have given you a border dash left. See, border dash left 6 pixels solid red. Here I have given the bottom border dash bottom 6 pixels solid red. So you can try by yourself or else wait for my notepad explanation. Next we have the CSS rounded border. The border radius property is used to add rounded border to an element. We have 4 types of borders like normal border, rounded border and rounder border and roundest border. So we have these 4 types of examples. This is the example for the rounded border. And we have the normal, rounded 1, rounded 2, rounded 3. And in this we have the normal border, rounded border, rounder border and roundest border. So this is the example for the CSS rounded border. You can try by yourself or else wait for my notepad. And I have given you one note. The note is the border radius property is not supported in earlier version like Internet Explorer and earlier which have come now newly, so it won't support for the earlier version. And we have all the CSS border properties at a time, so you can see like border, it sets all the border properties in one declaration. Border dash bottom sets all the bottom border properties in one declaration. Border dash bottom dash color, it says the color of the bottom border. Border dash bottom dash style, it sets the style of the bottom border. Border dash bottom width, it sets the width of the bottom border. If you have a pic, take a screenshot and keep in your mobile. It will be very helpful for you when you create your web pages. So border dash color, it sets the color of the 4 borders. Border left sets the left border property in one declaration. Border left color, it sets the color of the left border. Border left style, same as, sets the style of the left border. Border left width, it sets the width of the left border. Now we have the border right color. It sets the color of the right border, same. It sets the style of the right border, width. It sets the width of the right border. Border dash style, it sets the style for the 4 borders. Border top, it sets all the top border properties in one declaration. Border top color, it sets the color of the bottom border. Border top style, it sets the style of the top border. Width, it sets the top border. It sets the width of the top border. Border width, it sets the width of the 4 borders. So we have today completed our CSS border property, CSS border style, CSS border width, CSS border color, CSS border individuality sites, CSS border shortened property and CSS rounded border. If I have new version, new earliest version of my web browser, so I can't explain the CSS rounded border. If it possible, I will show the rounded border also. So these completed topics I will explain in my notepad explanation. So don't miss my notepad explanations. It is very important. I will tell very slow and with type, so don't miss it. And next topic we are seeing about CSS margin lesson number 8. So CSS margin lesson number 8, it is about the padding and margin. These two are very different. Padding is nothing but we have the two lines between the green and red. So this is the in between of the two lines is called padding, and margin is different. So we are going to see about margin in our tomorrow classes. So don't miss it. Please do subscribe, like, share and comment, and subscribe to my channel. Signing off, Tarika Dedipya. Bye.